بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وفقها في الدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم افتح علينا بحكمتك وانشر علينا برحمتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the last few sessions in our study of the stories of the Quran and reflection and pondering of the meanings of these stories, we went through the story of Nuh alayhi salam and the people of Nuh alayhi salam, the first people to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their pattern of shirk, in their pattern of associating the idols in the worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we saw how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave earth, gave humanity a new beginning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the disbelievers and gave a fresh beginning to the earth with the progeny of Nuh alayhi salam, and made and annihilated all the disbelievers, all the sinners, all the transgressors from the face of the earth, and started the believer generation again with the progeny, with the children of Nuh alayhi salam, who is considered the second father of humanity, as all the human beings that lived after the flood of the people of Nuh alayhi salam were of the children of Nuh alayhi salam. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about a new people. From the progeny of Nuh alayhi salam, his son Sam or Sham. And of that, of his son Sam, there were the people of Ad. The people of Ad were people that settled in southern Arabia. And they were considered Arabs. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith said, the prophets of the Arabs are four. They are Ad, the prophet of Ad, who is Hud alayhi salam, Salih, the prophet of Thamud, prophet Shu'aib, and then in the hadith he said, وَنَبِيُّكَ and your prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Arab, the ancient Arabs are divided into different sects, different tribes. And of the tribes, ancient tribes of Arabs is known the original Arabs. And that those are the Arabs of Yemen, and the Arabs of Ad, and the Arabs of Thamud. And then the newer Arabs called the Arabis, Al-Arab Al-Musta'riba. And they are the progeny of Ismail alayhi salam, who was not an Arab, but he was married into an Arabic tribe of Jurhum. And from the progeny of Ismail alayhi salam comes Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the tribe of Quraysh. So those people of Ad are from the ancient original Arab tribes that settled in southern Arabia right after the generation of Nuh alayhi salam. And it is not really well known how many generations passed between Nuh alayhi salam and the generation of Hud, our prophet, that we will ponder on his story inshallah tonight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the area where they lived, where the people of Ad lived, and he called it Al-Ahqaf. Al-Ahqaf meaning, the meaning of Al-Ahqaf is the area, the hills, the rolling hills that are basically sandy, mostly sand hills and sand dunes. And the Al-Ahqaf is also the name of the area in southern Arabia, which is currently, a lot of the scholars put it in the empty quarter in southern Arabia. And it is between the Sultanate of Oman and the Republic of Yemen, and it is within the Saudi Arabian area in the south east part of Saudi Arabia today. Just to give you a geographic background of where the scholars place the people of Ad and the dwelling and the settlement of people of Ad. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the characteristic, gives us a background, a geographical background, and also a socio-economic, political background of the people of Ad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the people of Ad in the Quran, and he said in Surah Al-A'raf that they were the heirs of the earth after the people of Nuh alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells people of Ad, admonishing the people of Ad, وَذْكُرُوا إِذْ جَعَلَكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَوْمِ نُوحٍ, and remember, give call and remembrance that Allah, He made you inheritors, the heirs of the earth, after the people of Nuh alayhi salam. And at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the people of Ad, that they were the mightiest nation on the face of the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave that tribe or the nation of Ad a lot of power. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَزَادَكُمْ فِي الْخَلْقِ بَسْطًا in the same verse in Surah Al-A'raf 69. And He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gave you a stature tall among the nations. So they were a superior power in the known world at that time. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala documents in the book of the Quran. But yet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us that they were the first people to deviate from the righteous path after Nuh alayhi salam, after the generation of Nuh alayhi salam. After the flood of Nuh alayhi salam, there were no disbelievers left on the face of the earth. All the people that were left on the face of the earth were believers. But the first people to deviate and to go back to the worship of idols after the generation of Nuh alayhi salam were those people of Ad. So what were the characteristics of the people of Ad? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again gives us a very beautiful picture, very detailed about the geographical, the political, and the economical picture, the economical situation of the people of Ad. He tells us that the people of Ad were powerful. They were the superpower on the face of the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that they were strong. وَزَادَكُمْ فِي الْخَلْقِ بَسْطًا Allah gave them among all the creatures, all the people, all the nations on the face of the earth, they were tall in stature. They were superior. They had supremacy in their power over other nations. And then they were rich. Not only they were power physically in their armies and in their build, they also had wealth. They had resources. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them and admonishes them in Surah Al-Shu'ara, Verse 132 and 133. And yeah, freely fear Him, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who bestowed upon you freely all that you know, all the bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. And yet there were more. I mean, you can imagine who Ad is. And this is a very relevant picture. This is not a story of ancient nation that came and passed. It is in a way, but in other ways, it is in the book of guidance, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we can reflect, we can correlate, we can understand what the people of Ad, how they were, and what happens to the people that follow in the footsteps of the people of Ad. So other than their power, they were the mightiest nation on the face of the earth. They were the superpower on the face of the earth. They were the wealthiest nation on the face of the earth. And you don't even see that today. Not necessarily the mightiest nation on the face of the earth may not be the wealthiest nation on the face of the earth. But Ad was both, and yet they had a very monumental civilization. They took advantage of their power, and they took advantage of their might. They took advantage of the richness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they built places. And they had a wondrous city. A city that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in Surah Al-Fajr when He says, إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ الَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ Allah describes their capital, their city, Iram. And He said, Iram of the lofty pillars. We don't know exactly what Iram looked like. And many scholars contemplated and described that, and they said it was a city of tents that the likes of which never been built again. But Allahu A'lam, Allah only knows what the Iram was. Allah tells us the likes of which لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد, the like of which of Iram was not created in the land. So this had this monumental. Imagine this. They had the wealth, they had the power, and they had this huge civilization. And they were building monuments, they were building places, they were carving palaces into the rocks, and they were building places that they don't even need. And here's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells about them. How they became, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed all the bounties upon them, instead of going back and being humble before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, instead of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they deviated from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the first trigger of their deviation was their arrogance. And you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about them, about their power. When a nation feels they're the mightiest, they can do whatever they want. They can knock down anything they want to, and they start feeling an arrogance. And they felt like there is nothing more powerful than them. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Fussilat, verse 15. فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّ قُوَّةِ عَاد. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as for Ad, they were arrogant in the land without right. They were arrogant, wrongfully arrogant in the land on earth. And they said, who is mightier than us in strength? They looked around them and all the nations in the world, all the tribes around them, everybody was less strong than they are. And they felt that they are the superpower. And they said, who is mightier than us? Allah answers them. And he said, we have to remember this, brothers and sisters. He said, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُمْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةً. Don't they see that Allah who created them was mightier in strength than they are? They're asking, who is mightier than us? And they forget Allah. They think about their power and they forget the power of Allah. They look at, they admire what they have and they forget who gave them that power in the first place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and they used to deny our signs. They used to deny the bounties. They denied the gift. They denied the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over them. And adding to this arrogance, they were tyrants. They started oppressing other nations. They started boasting off their power and their might. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes what their prophet Hud alayhi salam was telling them in Surah Shu'ara, verse 128 through 130. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says on the tongue of Hud alayhi salam, when he was admonishing his people with the inspiration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ أَتَبْنُونَ بِكُلِّ رِيعٍ آيَةً تَعْبَثُونَ وَتَتَّخِذُونَ مَصَانِعَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَخْلُدُونَ وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ. Listen to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonishing them, and Hud is telling them, do you build high palaces on every high place, on every high top mountain? They build a great monumental palace that they don't even use. And he said, this is all total waste while you don't even live in them. Why is that? Because the purpose of building these monumental places is not for their service. Is they're just boastful. They're just showing their might. They're showing their power. They're showing that they can do it. And Prophet said, this is purposeless. This has no purpose. This is useless. And then he said, وَتَتَّخِذُونَ مَصَانِعَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَخْلُدُونَ. And you get yourselves palaces or fine buildings as if you were going to live forever. And all of their buildings and all of their civilization, they have self-admiration. They have boastfulness. They were arrogant. As if they were going to live forever. As if they were leaving all these monuments to show that this is what they are. And they expect that will be going on forever. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a different plan for them. And yet, here is the last characteristic of the people of Ad. وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ. And when you see somebody, when you attack somebody, when you oppress somebody, you seize them as tyrants. They were oppressors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that not only they were using their power and their might to boast and to show off, and they denied the bounty of Allah, but yet they were subjugating other nations to oppression. And then when they were attacking others, they had no mercy. They had no mercy in their attacks. They had no humanitarian value in our today's language. And then when they attack without mercy. They kill, and they ruin, and they annihilate. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing them what they are doing, showing them their sin, showing them who what they are made of. So what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? He exposed them for what they are. He sent them a prophet, Salih alayhi salam. And he started preaching to them, trying to get them back to the right path and tell them where they went wrong. And the most severe sin that these people had was the highest sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive. إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. Allah does not forgive shirk. Allah does not tolerate shirk. Allah does not forgive associating with His worship, and He forgives everything else to whomever He pleases. So the first sin that they did is they started worshiping idols, and the most severe sin. And then when Hud alayhi salam, they refused that. They refused his admonition. They refused his message. And they said, that's what our fathers were worshiping, and that's what we will continue to worship. And they rejected the message of Tawheed. And the second thing is they had disbelief in the hereafter. And if you look at the people of Nuh and all the sins before the people of Ad, they were the first to declare their disbelief in the hereafter. So now they actually presented a new sin to humanity. Disbelieve in meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Disbelieve in the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes that in their words. And when they were talking to each other, and they say, أَيَعِدُكُمْ أَنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِتْتُمْ وَكُنْتُمْ تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَنَّكُمْ مُخْرَجُونَ هَيْهَاتَ هَيْهَاتَ لِمَا تُوعَدُونَ إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوثِينَ. They're talking about Hud, and they said, does he promise you that when you have died and you have become dust and bones, you shall come out alive and be resurrected? Far, very far is that which you are promised. They said, this is not going to happen. There is nothing but our life in this world. That's what they said. We die and we live. There is nothing. Like the pagans of Quraysh, they said, أَرْحَامٌ تَدْفَعْ وَأَرْضٌ تَبْلَعْ. It's just the wombs that give the children out and the earth that swallows the body. And there is nothing else. They said, there is no life after death. They said, we die and we live and we are not going to be resurrected. So this is what one of the first people to disbelieve in the hereafter. And it really correlates with their psyche. It correlates with that what they believe in. These are people that are tyrants. These are people that thought that there is nothing mightier than they are. There is no one that is more powerful than they are, and they answer to no one. That's what they said. Who is mightier than us? Who is more powerful than us? So believing in the day of judgment, by definition, tells them that they are responsible and they have to answer before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But because of their arrogance that they wanted to answer to no one, they just rejected the whole idea of resurrection. Rejected the whole idea of coming before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ultimate judge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most fair judge. And they said, this is not going to happen. We're going to enjoy our life. We are going to enjoy our civilization. We're going to enjoy our power. And when we die, we die. And that's it. And there is two types of disbelief in the hereafter. One type is to completely reject resurrection. To completely reject that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise people up. And will put them to judgment. And the second type of disbelief is sort of a denial. That if it happens, then we will fare out well because we are the most favorable people, because we talk to God and God talks back to us, because Allah favors us, because we cannot go to a bad place. And that's when you see in Surah Al-Kahf that person that had the garden and he was having a discussion with his believer friends. He said, مَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةً. I don't think the day of judgment will come. وَلَا رَدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي. But if it happens, لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهَا مُقَلَبًا. Then I think I'll find better than my garden. So that's another, it's just the denial of reality that we are responsible before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has heaven, but also has hellfire. That if we do good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us. But if we don't do good, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish us. And they completely dodged off that idea of punishment by denying the day of judgment. And they were the first people to do that, as far as we know, on the face of the earth. Wallahu a'lam. And then they did a sin that you will see it's a pattern of most people, of the most population that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroys, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes in this dunya, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the punishment for them, hastily, but immediately in this dunya before the day of judgment. And that is blind following of their leaders. When they blind follow their misguided leader, misguided leaders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes the people in general. Even if there was someone else that is leading that disbelief, even some people that are taking the banner, so to speak, and they are misguiding others, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if someone follows another person, in that misguidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the followers into accountability. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us who led the disbelief among the people of Ad, the usual suspect that we saw in the story of Nuh alayhi salam, the elite, the aristocrats, the leadership, the chieftain of the people. They are the ones that deviate first, and people follow them in their deviation. And here's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Mu'minun, says about the people of Ad, وَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِلِقَاءِ الْآخِرَةِ وَأَتْرَفْنَاهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah describes these people. And the chiefs, the leaders of the people who disbelieved and denied in the meeting in the hereafter. They denied the day of judgment. And whom we had given luxurious and comforts of this life. وَأَتْرَفْنَاهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. مُتْرَفِينَ. They were living a life of luxury. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them all that bounty. They were leaders, they were rich, they were wealthy, and they led their people into the disbelief, into the sin. And they said, what did they say? He is no more like than a human being like you are. He eats what you eat, and he drinks from what you drink, and if you obey him, then you are truly losers. And the people believed them, and the people followed them, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the entire population as sinners. And the same thing in Surah Hud, verse 59. And Hud, alayhi salam, was honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by naming an entire surah after his story, alayhi salam. And in that surah, in verse 59, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتِلْكَ عَادٌ جَحَدُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ وَعَصَوْا رُسُلَ وَاتَّبَعُوا أَمْرَ كُلِّ جَبَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. Such were Ad people. They rejected the signs of their Lord and cherisher. Disobeyed his messengers, in plural. How many messengers the people of Ad had? They had only one messenger. But just like when we were studying Nuh, if you reject one messenger, you're rejecting all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they all came with the same message. They all came with Tawheed. They all came with the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They all came with La ilaha illallah. And when ones reject La ilaha illallah, believe in Allah, believe in His angels, believe in the day of judgment, believe in the books of Allah, believing in the messengers of Allah, all the pillars of Iman, when they are rejected, like it's rejecting all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah says about these people, وَعَصَوْا رُسُلَ. They obeyed all the disobeyed all the messengers. وَاتَّبَعُوا. And they followed the command, أَمْرَ كُلِّ جَبَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. The command of every powerful, obstinate transgressor. That was the choice of the people of Ad. And these were the people of Ad. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does is He sent them with His mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not punish anyone before He gives these people the chance. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivers the message. And this is in the Quran. وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. We will not send the torment and the punishment until we send the messengers first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when takes someone or some people into accountability, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would take him fully into accountability, knowing that they have received the message in full. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His mercy, send them from among them, their brotherhood. Hud was from the people of Ad. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the righteous Hud to carry the message to the people of Ad. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا. And to Ad we send one of their own brothers, Hud. What did he say? The same thing that Nuh alayhi salam said. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. O my people, worship Allah alone. You have no other God but Him. This is La ilaha illallah in its entirety. And that is the message of Nuh. That was the message of Hud. And you will see that will be the message of every messenger. Inshallah, we will reflect upon their stories. It is the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-Tawheed. That's why understanding Tawheed and practicing Tawheed is the essence of religion. It is the essence of Islam, the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends Hud alayhi salam. And he sent them with as a caller to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always sends messengers with the message of mercy, calling lovingly to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Punishment and warning always comes late. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the prophets, mubashirin wa mundirin. Give first the glad tiding. Tell him that there is a loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a loving God, a forgiving God, a God that will repent upon you, a God that will accept you if you come back, no matter what your sins are, as long as you repent sincerely. But then also warn them that this is not a game, that this is not a joke, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rahmanun Rahim, Azizun Duntiqam. Allah is all merciful, all gracious, but He also all powerful, He is mighty, and His punishment is the most severe. نَبِّ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. Tell my servants that I am the all merciful, I am the all forgiving, but my punishment is also the most painful and the most severe. And here's Hud alayhi salam, following the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and delivering the message of mercy to his people. What did he say? In Surah Hud, verses 50 through 52. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ إِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا مُفْتَرُونَ. First he gives them the basic message. He said, worship Allah. You have no Lord but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abandon those idols. There is no one, no deity that is worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In antum illa muftarun, you know that you have just invented those names, invented those idols. It is just but a lie, and this is all just a falsehood. Abandon that and go back to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya qawmi la as'alukum alayhi ajran. إن أجري إلا على الله إلا على الذي فطرني أفلا تعقلون. He said, what am I going to get out of this? I'm not going to ask you for any reward. He said, here I am, I'm bringing you this message, I'm bringing you the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I want nothing. I want no reward from you. I don't want you to make me a king, I don't want you to make me a chief, I don't want you to make me a wealthy man. All I want is I just deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and my reward, my gift will come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can't you see? أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Can't you comprehend? وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. He called them to the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that my people ask Allah for forgiveness. اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. It's like what Nuh promised his people. He said, استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا. Allah will give you more wealth. And rain meant wealth, meant fertility. And he said, Allah will send the heaven, the sky, with abundant rain over you and give you all the wealth you want. You will have no drought. They were living in southern Arabia, and rain is scarce. And they needed that. And Allah said, just ask Allah for forgiveness, and Allah will send you abundant water. You will use it. And not only that, you think you're mighty and you're powerful, if you ask forgiveness of Allah, and if you obey Allah, وَيَزِدْكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ. And Allah will make you mightier and even more powerful. Don't think that belief, Iman is not weak. Iman is not a sign of weakness. Islam is not a sign of being exposed to all kind of abuse. Iman is powerful. Faith is powerful. And he said, if you ask Allah for forgiveness, you will even be stronger and mightier. But then your strength will be directed in the right direction. It's not going to be used to oppress others. It's not going to be used to subject others to humility, to oppression. وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ. That's what he told him. If you, when you take others, when you seize others, you send with tyranny. Then Allah will make you mightier. But your might, your power will be directed in the right direction. وَلَا تَتَوَلَّوْا مُجْرِمِينَ. And do not turn your backs to me. Do not go away as criminals, as sinners in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the da'wah of Hud alayhi salam. Most beautiful. Not offensive at all. Just come to Allah. We'll make you better. We'll give you more wealth. We'll give you more power. And we'll forgive your sins. What else do you want? And then reminding them. They thought that they were the wealthiest people on earth. they're the most powerful, wealthy on earth. He said, who do you think gave you that power? Who do you think makes you, made you this, this superpower that you're bragging about? Who do you think did that to you? Allah. وَاتَّقُوا الَّذِي أَمَدَّكُمْ بِمَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And keep your duty to him. Fear him who has aided you with all good things that you know, with all the might, all the power that you enjoy. أَمَدَّكُمْ بِأَنْعَامٍ وَبَنِينَ. He aided you with cattle. Cattle meant wealth. وَبَنِينَ. And children. Children meant power. Numbers. وَجَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. And the gardens and the springs. Who do you think gave you all of that? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserve to be worshipped alone? Doesn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala worth to be worshipped without any association? Of course, la ilaha illallah. And then also warn them. Like we said, it is always a dual message. Tabshir wa inzar. Give the glad tidings, but warn them that there is consequences to your deeds. That if you don't follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, there will be consequences. And you have to know these consequences. Because it's true, it is haq. Jannah is haq and nar is haq. Paradise is true and also hellfire is true. And the Muslim will have a balanced view. The believer has to have a balanced view to both of them and keep both realities in front of him or her as we go through daily life. واذكر أخا عاد إذ أنذر قومه بالأحقاف وقد خلت النذر من بين يديه ومن خلفه ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم. I fear for you the torment of a mighty day, a torment of a terrible day. And that can be the day of judgment, and it can be the day that they will be tormented and punished in this life on the face of the earth. He's warning them that come back to Allah. فروا إلى الله. Run back to Allah. Everyone who you fear, you run away from. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you fear Allah, where do you go? Where do you go? From the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You go back to Allah. That is your safety place. You fear Allah, you get closer to Him. Anything, any person you fear, you run away from. You distance yourself from, except Allah. The more you fear Allah, the closer you become to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what he's telling them. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How was their response? How did they respond to the message of Hud alayhi salam? قال الملأ الذين كفروا من قومه إنا لنراك في سفاهة وإنا لنظنك من الكاذبين. Look at the response. That didn't make any logical sense. The leaders of those who disbelieved among his people said, verily we see you are in foolishness. Said, you're but a fool calling us to these things. And verily we think you are one of the liars. We don't think that you're telling the truth. What proof did they have for that? What is the message of Hud? What was wrong about the message of Hud alayhi salam? What was foolish about the message of Hud? They were not discussing that. They just said, we think you're a liar. We think you're a madman. The same thing that they accused Nuh alayhi salam. The same accusation that you will see repeating itself to most of the messengers that came after Nuh alayhi salam, who was the first messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the people that reject the truth are bankrupt. They're totally bankrupt. They have no argument. They have nothing to offer. So they start demeaning others. They start belittling the prophets. They start demeaning the truth. They have no other weapon other than ridicule, other than hiding the truth, other than putting it under the carpet, if they can. وَيَأْبَى اللَّهُ إِلَّا يُتِمَّ نُورًا. But Allah refuses but to fulfill and complete His light. They try. They try to put out the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by blowing at it. Allah tells us that, throws that picture for us. It's a comical picture almost. يُرِدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُ نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ. They try to put out the light of Allah with their mouths. وَيَعْبَى اللَّهُ إِلَّا يُتِمَّ نُورًا. وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورِهِ. Allah will fulfill and complete His light. Allah will fulfill His promise. But we have to have faith. We have to believe in that. We have to be patient. We have to keep in our mind that belief, in our heart, that complete faith that Allah will fulfill His light.
that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fulfill His message. No matter how dark the road is, no matter how long and how hard, no matter what we see, how discouraging the reality of today is, we have to understand that Allah has a promise that this will be fulfilled. Because Allah chose this religion to His people. From the time of Nuh, from the time of Hud, from the time of Saleh, until the day of judgment. And Allah will support the believers, no matter what. And that is the coolness that comes into the heart of the believers in dark days, in hard times. And they accused Hud alayhi salam by being a madman, by being a liar. And they said, Ya Hud, قالوا يا هود ما جئتنا ببينة وما نحن بتاركي آلهتنا عن قولك وما نحن لك بمؤمنين. See their argument. They said, Oh Hud, no evidence have you brought to us. And we see with Nuh and Hud alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not speak of miracles. Does not speak of miracles that they brought with them as major miracles like splitting the sea open, or like we see with Musa alayhi salam, or with Ibrahim alayhi salam, with the fire would not touch his body, would not hurt him. That was not the case at the time of Nuh and Hud. It will change with the time of Saleh, the next prophet. But at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to humanity through evidence. Not a physical evidence, but the evidence of the heart, the evidence of the mind, the evidence of the logic. These are people who are close to Nuh, they are close to Adam, and they know La ilaha illallah. They know the truth, but they are hiding the truth. They're trying to cover it up. They're trying to deny it while they completely understand it in their heart. And that's why there is no need to split the moon for them. There is no need to burst the seas open, because they know the truth. And the argument of Hud is very simple and is very clear to them. But here's what they said. He said, you really did not bring us an evidence that you are the prophet. And we will not just leave our gods because you're telling us so. We're not just going to abandon our idols because you're asking us to do so. وَمَا نَحْنُ لَكَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ And we are not believers in you. إِنَّ قُولُ إِلَّا اَعْتَرَاكَ بَعْضُ آلِهَتِنَا بِسُوءٍ What we think is some of our gods, some of our idols, have seized you with evil. They touch you, they casted a spell upon you. That the idols hurt you, so you now, you became the madman that you are, and you're saying all of these foolishness about La ilaha illallah. That's our explanation for what you're saying. And that is not even an argument that a five-year-old would accept. They're asking Hud for a proof of La ilaha illallah. What proof do they have for their theory? That their Arak idols actually casted a spell upon Hud alayhi salam. Of course they had no proof, and they are being held guilty by their own admissions. They want the proof. You brought the bid'ah, you brought the innovation, you brought the idols, you give me a proof that these are gods, that these are deities, that they have anything that they can harm or they can benefit. And they cannot harm or benefit nobody. But they're asking for a proof while they have no proof and no evidence for anything they're doing. And you see the falsehood of their way of thinking. And then he said, قَالَ إِنِّي أُشْهِدُ اللَّهِ I make witness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as I call Allah to witness, and I bear you witness that I am free from what you have ascribed as partners to worship. So he exonerated himself from his people. But why his people acted this way? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that their arrogance. They felt like they're above all humans. They are the superpower. They are the mightiest nation on the earth. And those elite are the elite of the elite. They're the creme of the crop, right? They're the top. Who is who to come and tell them, change your way of life? To them, who is who to tell them, change your way of worship? Change, that they always are fearful of their status in the society. That's the problem with the leadership. That's the problem with the elite. The elite are in a certain society because of a certain circumstances that put them up there. And any disturbance in the society, it threatens their position. And no matter what the truth is, they don't want to listen to it. They're not interested in the truth. They're not interested of what's right. They're interested in preserving the status quo because they like the status quo. they like where they are. And if people started following Hud and they started obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then their status may change. They may, the status of the righteous people will become higher, and the status of the disbelievers, the oppressors, will become lower. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن الله أعز بالإسلام بيوتا أو رفع بالإسلام بيوتا وخفض بيوتا أو كما قال عليه السلام. Allah elevates certain people with Islam and Iman. Allah puts down others with Islam and Iman. So they were fearful for their own status, and their argument with their own arrogance to their people is, he is but a human being, and why should we listen to a human being? And they said, ما هذا إلا بشر مثلكم يأكل مما تأكلون منه ويشرب مما تشربون ولئن أطعتم بشرا مثلكم إنكم إذا لخاسرون. They said, he is just not but a human being. He eats from what you eat and he drinks from what you drink. And if you obey a human being, then you are a loser. What is wrong with a human being bringing the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why the message of truth, can the message of truth be affected of who brings it? Doesn't matter who brings the message of truth. You have to look at the message, even if you don't like the messenger. Even if you don't feel the messenger is worthy of the message, but Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalata. Allah knows where his message should be. So any messenger that Allah chooses is the right person to carry that message. But even if the disbelievers don't like the messenger, like they said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Allah said in the Quran, لولا نزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. When this Quran be revealed to one of the great people of the two cities of Mecca and Taif, they didn't like the Quran to be revealed on Muhammad ibn Abdullah, the orphan, the not very wealthy person. They felt like it should go to Urwa ibn Mas'ud or Al-Walid ibn Al-Mughira, or one of their elite people. And the same thing with Hud. He said, he is just a human being. He eats what you eat and he drinks what. Why should you believe him? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in Surah Al-A'raf. أَوَعَجِبْتُمْ أَنْ جَاءَكُمْ ذِكْرٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ مِّنْكُمْ لِيُنْذِرَكُمْ. Why is it wondrous? Why is it weird to you? Why is it not believable that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals his revelation to a man of you? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Isra, verse 94, وَمَا مَنَعَ النَّاسَ أَن يُؤْمِنُوا إِذْ جَاءَهُمُ الْهُدَى إِلَّا أَن قَالُوا أَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ بَشَرًا رَسُولًا. Did not prevent people to believe in the messengers unless when they say, did Allah send a human being to be a messenger? And Allah responds to that. He said, well, I would send an angel. If you have angels walking around in the marketplace, you send the messenger from the same kind, from people that can understand that messenger. The call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes from someone who's from that within the people, knows their language, knows their culture. مَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ. Allah said, we have not sent a messenger unless they are on the same tongue of their people. So he can explain to them, he can show them the message. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. And the tongue of the people, as the scholar said, it's not only the language, it's the entire cultural thing. It's everything. The messenger comes from within the people. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him an angel to bring the message, he said, you know what? You're an angel, you're not like us. You want us to pray five times? You're an angel, you can pray five times. But we're human beings, we cannot pray five times. You want us to fast the month of Ramadan? Well, you're an angel, you can fast the month of Ramadan. But we're just human beings, we cannot do it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends those messengers as role models, people that live the message and show us. They're human beings like we are. And in evidence of that, they eat from what we eat and drink from what we drink. That's their strength, that's not their weakness, like the disbelievers trying to show. Their strength is they are human beings. And they show us what a human being should be. And it is doable by a human being, not by Superman, not by an archangel. It's by a normal human being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for the revelation and chose for the message. And their arrogance led them to say, there is nothing mightier than us. And they forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is mightier than anyone of his creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the mightiest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the almighty. Al-Jabbar, Al-Qahhar, Al-Aziz, Al-Mutakabbir. La ilaha illallah. Subhanallahi amma yushrikun. And then just following in the footsteps of shaitan with his arrogance, with his pride, they followed the shaitan with inad, with the obstinacy of shaitan, with the stubbornness of shaitan. And they finally told Hud, told Prophet Hud alayhi salam, قالوا سواء علينا أوعظت أم لم تكن من الواعظين. It's not going to help. They said, it is the same to us, whether you preach to us or you don't preach to us. They told Hud, save your breath. Don't preach no more to us. Don't preach any more to us. We're not going to listen. We have made our mind up. Remind us of the people of Nur. كلما دعوتهم لتغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا. The same way. Call upon them, they put their fingers in their ears and they put their garments over their head and they insist on their position. And the same thing with the people of Hud. أصروا. They said, don't waste your breath preaching to us. We're not going to listen. Whether you preach or you don't preach, the results is the same. And then, like we said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are certain sins, there are certain things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not tolerate. Allahu Halim, Allah has forbearance, endless forbearance. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws limits. There are hudud to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts for people. And when people transgress these limits, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them. And we saw one of the limits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drew to the people of Nuh when they challenge Allah. When they challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to the challenge. No one can challenge Allah. No one can dare Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the people of Hud fell into that same trap, that same sin. They called a challenge to Hud. They said, قَالُوا أَجِئْتَنَا لِنَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ وَحْدَهُ وَنَذَرُوا مَا كَانَ يَعْبُدُ آبَاؤُنَا فَأْتِنَا بِمَا تَعِدُنَا إِن كُنْتَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. They said, you have come to us that we should worship Allah alone and forsake that which our fathers used to worship. So bring us the punishment. Bring it on. Bring that wherewith you have threatened us. If you are of the truthful. If you are really truthful, then don't bring the mercy of Allah. Don't show us the mercy of Allah. Don't show us the forgiveness. Don't show us the sign. Give us the torment. Show us the torment. That is the absolute rudeness. That is the ultimate obstinacy. This is the ultimate disbelief. He said, we are so confident that you are a liar that don't show us anything but the torment of Allah. If you are really truthful, bring on the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like Nuh turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Nuh told his Lord, إِنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصَرْ. I am overcome. So help me. So give me support. And that's what Hud turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said, قَالَ رَبِّ انصُرْنِي بِمَا كَذَّبُونَ. Oh my Lord, help me because they denied. They denied me. They denied the message. They denied what you have sent me with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded, قَالَ عَمَّا قَلِيلٍ لَيُصْبِحُنَّ نَادِمِينَ. It's going to be only a short while. In a little while, they will sure be regretful. They will regret what they have done. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the challenge. And when Hud got that acceptance and that message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he went back to his people and he said, فَكِيدُونِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ لَا تُنظِرُونَ إِنِّي تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ رَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ مَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ آخِذٌ بِنَاصِيَتِهَا إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. He said, so plot against me, all of you. Like Nuh alayhi salam. He said, go ahead now, show me your plot. You're challenging Allah, we accepting the challenge. Allah accepts the challenge. He said, now go ahead and plot. Whatever you can do. Like Nuh said, وَأَجْمِعُوا أَمْرَكُمْ. Bring whomever you want to plot with you. And the same thing Hud said, فَكِيدُونِي جَمِيعًا. All of you come and plot against me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And give me no respite. Give me no respite. Just don't give me any chance. Don't give me a break. Now people, when they say all people are against you, so just give me a break. Right? Hud said, give me no, don't give me a break. Go do whatever you can. Allahu Aziz. Allah is all powerful. These people are fooled by the forbearance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not tolerate that. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُمْهِلْ وَلَا يُهْمِلْ. Allah gives respite. Allah gives them time. But He does not neglect. Allah never neglects anybody. Allah is all watchful over His people. So he said, إِنِّي تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. I rely on Allah, my Lord and your Lord. He said, there is not a living thing unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is holding its forelock. Allah is in control of everything. What are you talking about? He said, you are challenging Allah to bring on the punishment and the torment. Don't you know that Allah is in control of every living thing on the face of this earth and in the universe and in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? مَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ أَخِذٌ بِرَاصِيَتِهَا إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Indeed, my Lord is on the straight path. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا. But if you turn away, if you insist on your position, فَقَدْ أَبْلَغْتُكُمْ مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ. I have delivered my message. مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ إِلَيْكُمْ. He's given his final talk to them. He said, I have fulfilled my duties. Because he's a messenger of Allah. He has a mission. And he wants to make sure that he delivers the mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him. And the messengers of Allah are the most fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the most fearful people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they know the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he is before his Lord. He is just showing he has done everything he can. And he is making them witnesses over that. He said, I have given you everything that I have got. I have given you all the message that was revealed to me. فَقَدْ أَبْلَغْتُكُمْ مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ إِلَيْكُمْ وَيَسْتَخْلِفْ رَبِّي قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ وَلَا تَضُرُّونَهُ شَيْئًا إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَفِيظٍ. Allah will substitute you for people that are better than you, people that are other than you. This is your end. And they did not believe that. They were too arrogant to believe that. They were too arrogant to believe that there is any might that is bigger than their might. There is no power bigger than their power. They refused to believe that. And then comes the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings them a punishment in a very ironic way. Now these are people that love the rain, that wants the rain to come back to their dry land so they can have more wealth, they can have more water. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send them a cloud, a big, dark cloud after a period of drought. When they were really longing for rain. And here they are, they see a dark cloud coming their way, coming to their place, coming to their city, coming to Iram. And what do they think? What do they say, these arrogant people? فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرُنَا. They were happy to see that cloud. They were delighted to see that dark, big cloud coming towards them. When they saw it, as a dense cloud coming towards their valleys, they said, this is a cloud bringing us rain. And that is their arrogance. And that is from the istidraj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this picture, we have to ponder a little bit about this. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not just send them a sayha, did not just destroy them completely, but send them this in a picture of a dark cloud that is really very promising of a very good season of rain. Because of what we call istidraj. Istidraj is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lured people in more into denial. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala determines to torment people, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that these people are hopeless, and that's only in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes them feel that they're even more powerful. وَنَسْتَدْرِجُهُمْ فِي طُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. And we will increase them in their tyranny. So their blindness will even become worse. They cannot even see now. They're so into their sin that they cannot see the truth. And that is the istidraj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to ponder in that in a way that when we see things going in the way of the disbelievers, when we see things, jazakallah khair, when we see things not going in the way of the believers, and Allah is putting the Muslims and the people of Allah, the people of God, in trials and tribulation. And you look at the other side, and you see there are things that are going their way. And you might think, well, what's going on? What's wrong with this picture? You have to know this pattern of Allah, the plot of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah tells us when He sent the punishment to the people of Hud, the worst, one of the worst people that ever inhabited the face of the earth, He sent it to them in a face, in a way of a glad tiding, something that will increase their power, something that will increase even more their wealth. And they were happy with it. So لا يغرنك تقلب الذين كفروا في البلاد. Do not be fooled by the power and the might of the disbelievers on the face of the earth. This is a verse of the Quran. Allah just gives them respite, and Allah has a plot. وأملي لهم in Surah Al-Qalam. أملي لهم إن كيدي متين. I give them more because my plot is more strong than their plot. It's stronger than their plot. The kaid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the best of plotters. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us this picture that we should not just pass by. We should really ponder over that. We should understand how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala works. And it may not be the way we want things to work, but Allah is more wise. Allah is more knowledgeable. And Allah is more powerful. And Allah sends them this cloud that they become very happy when they see it. And when they say, they have the عَارِضٌ مُمْتَرُنَا. Here is the cloud that is going to bring us rain. Allah responds, بَلْ هُوَ مَسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ رِيحٌ فِيهَا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. This is the wind that is bringing the torment to you. تُدَمِّرُ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ بِأَمْرِ رَبِّهَا. This will destroy everything with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the wind, those mighty people, the people that engraved things in the rocks, that they built things on top of the mountains, that they had the city of Iram, that the likes of which was never created on the face of the earth, and they filled it with sin, and they filled it with disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy them? In a humiliating way, by wind, by just blowing them off, because that's what they are worth. And how did that happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us even more detail. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَذَّبَتْ عَاد فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عَذَابِي وَنُذُرْ Surah Al-Qamar. عَاد belied the prophets. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عَذَابِي Then how terrible, how painful was my torment and my warnings. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا We send against them a furious wind. And صَرْصَر can mean cold wind and a pounding wind that keeps pounding and pounding and pounding. Now we, you know, in our last experience, we know the hurricane that hit New Orleans, and it's called Hurricane Katrina. How long did Hurricane Katrina was over New Orleans? Does anybody know? It was over New Orleans for less than 2 hours. That's it. Destroyed most of New Orleans and flooded the entire area and the whole coast of Mississippi in less than 2 hours. And this is not the rih that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about for sure. And here's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it. He said, رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا فِي يَوْمِ نَحْسٍ مُسْتَمِرٍ تَنْزِعُ النَّاسِ It plucks people out. These people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them first, how powerful, how mighty they are. وَسَادَكُمْ بَسْطًا They are physically powerful and everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just plucking them out with wind. كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ مُنْقَعِرٍ Just like they are the trunks of the stems of a palm tree that is dried and that has been cut off. Just being blown away in the wind. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عَذَابِي وَنُذُرْ وَأَمَّا عَادٌ In Surah Al-Haqq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes that. وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرٍ عَاتِيَةٍ سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا This wind, this fierce wind, this ferocious wind, Allah sends it upon them for 7 nights and 8 days. Not for 1 hour, for 2 hours, for 10 hours, for 20 hours, for 7 nights and 8 days. Kept pounding them with their arrogance. And Allah just blew him away completely. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes these mighty people, the superpower of that time, فَتَرَى الْقَوْمَ فِيهَا صَرْعَى كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٍ They were like hollow trunks of date palms. hollow trunks of palm trees just being blown away. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ Allah asking us now, when you look at mighty people, at powerful people that do whatever they want, we have to remember this. Allah said, do you see any remnants of the people of Ad? Do you see where their relics are? Do you see where their might is? Where is their empire? Where is their armies that they used to seize people with and kill people with? كأنهم أعجاز نخل منقعر. They're just like hollow trunks of palm tree being blown away in the wind. And that is the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The things that we derive from the story of Ad, from the story of people of Ad, we have to ponder over that, is the consequences of isti'la, the consequences of arrogance. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusts people with power, then that is a responsibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is placing in the hands of these people. And then when they become tyrants, when they become aggressors, when they develop their power to subject other people, like the people of Ad, وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ You used it to subject others, to oppress others. Then their end has to be like the people of Ad, without a doubt. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ Do you see their remnants? Do you see where they are now? And anybody who feels they are mighty, they are powerful, they are wealthy, they are healthy, they have to remember that Allahu Akbar, Allahu A'zam, Allahu Aghna, Allah is bigger, Allah is mightier, Allah is wealthier. Allah is above that. And people have to humble themselves. And nations have to humble themselves before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the lessons, because these lessons of the Quran are not irrelevant to our daily living today. They are there for a reason. They are not there so we can just be entertained by how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed certain people. Like I said, there will be the theme that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be people who reject Allah. Allah sends a messenger. They reject the messenger. Allah will destroy them. But why repeating the story? Because there is a different aspect for each and every different one of these nations. Now these were different. These people are different from the people of Noah. These people that felt they are mighty, they are powerful, and there is nothing more powerful than they are. And they used their power to oppress others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us how He blew them away. Just blew them away with the wind. And the type of punishment, always just think about that, ponder upon that. The type of punishment that Allah chooses for each nation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who drowned earth with misguidance, overwhelmed earth with idol worship, Allah drowned them. And those who thought that nothing can move them, Allah just blew them away. Allah chooses the humiliating punishment to fit the people that are committing the sins. And with that, inshallah, we will close. And we remember the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we have any bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to humble ourselves before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to make sure that we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and show our gratitude to His might and humble ourselves before His greatness. أقول قولي هذا سبحان الله سبحان ربي رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين